Javed ji, representatives of CSAC, IFPI, IMI, IPRS, and PPO. Ladies and gentlemen, to begin with, I congratulate the IMAI and the IFPI on organizing the dialogue, the Indian Music Convention. I'm thankful to IMAI for providing an opportunity to share my views on the role of collection societies. India is a land of culture and creativity, where music plays a prominent role. The Indian culture has been exposed to a dynamic changes, and the music has kept pace with the changing times. Our music has flair for new age and has boasted of the international presence. Keeping pace with the changing times, the Union Cabinet has approved its consent for accession to the WIPO international treaties, which facilitates international protection of domestic right holders. This is a landmark step in the history of copyright law and will empower the creative Indian authors and owners of the copyright by enabling a level playing field. Similarly, the Government of India has taken various steps to ensure the implementation of the objectives laid down under the National IPR Policy. The Copyright Office has been co-located with the other IPR units, namely Patent and Trademark. The Copyright Office has also made substantial improvements in its working so as to ensure efficiency and transparency. The office has digitalized the records related to registration. The communication to the stakeholders is being made through the electronic means. The traditional way of managing economic rights in the field of copyright and neighboring rights is through individual contracts. This is still the case with the publishing business. However, when it comes to the public performance or broadcasting of musical works, individual administration of rights is not feasible or possible. This is where the collective management, through the collective management organizations, becomes necessary. Such copyright societies are in the interest of both the right owners and the users. For right owners, such management is indispensable because they would themselves be unable to control the masses. For users, it is of great advantage to be able to conclude contracts with one party instead of having multiple contracts with thousands of right owners that would be not only time-consuming but difficult to manage. The very basis of copyright societies is the trust of owners and the authors of the work in the functioning of the administration of the copyright societies. Such trust is based on the efficiency, transparency, and accountability. The copyright society, not familiar with its members or its works it represents, fails in its task. It is a duty, its main duty consists of keeping and presenting detailed and precise information on the rights which it holds and the work it administers. So documentation is a key to smooth functioning of the copyright society. Documentation in the present context includes the repertoire of the work being administered, the assignment deed, the membership related documents, tariff scheme, distribution scheme, dispute settlement methodology, besides others. The repertoire of the society is its status and the capacity to represent authors and the owners of the work. The society must concentrate all its efforts on maintaining a repertoire which is as complete and possible and up to date. The society must necessarily publish their complete repertoire on their official websites so as to enable the general public to identify the rightful owners and the authors of the work and to ascertain whether a particular work is being administered by the society. It has been noticed that the copyright societies are not regularly publishing and updating their repertoire on their websites. The authors and the owners of the work expect fair reward of their work when exploited by public at large. This depends upon the tariff, the willingness of the clients to pay, and the collection efficiency of the society. The tariff scheme fixed by the society must be just and reasonable and should aim to maximize the availability of the work to the public. All those who use music for professional and commercial purposes should be treated as members of the corporate society, that is, as a client and not as users. It has been observed that such clients are generally not consulted during the fixation of the tariff scheme. It is therefore suggested that the clients may be awarded an opportunity to have an active participation during the fixation of the tariff. In addition to it, the decision process of fixing of royalties, the rationale for decision, and the information relied upon to make the decision should be clear to all and be made available at least to the clients and the members of the society. The distribution royalties to the authors and owners of the copyright work should be based on the principle of equality of treatment of all the members. Every copyright society should apply to the works in the repertoire of other society the same tariff, methods, and collection and distribution of royalties as those which it applies to the works in its own repertoire. The copyright society is obliged to distribute among its members all the revenue after deduction of permissible administrative and welfare expenses. Furthermore, in addition to the obligation of distribution of revenues to the society must make all efforts to identify the rightful owners and the authors of the work and to pay them their respective shares. In case such works are being exploited under the banner of the corporate society, the society should frame schemes to remunerate the authors of their or the legal heirs of such unknown authors or non-members and may maintain a separate account for this purpose. The corporate society must develop an IT-enabled system so that the members are able to track the exploitation of the works on a real-time basis. In India, people are generally not aware of the rights which exist in songs and music. I believe the copyright society should come up with an initiatives for mass awareness programs with an objective to change the attitude of the users. The government of India has taken several initiatives to make the general public aware of the copyright law and the impact of piracy on Indian music. DIPP has been regularly conducting workshops and seminars to sensitize the general public. A similar option may be considered by the creative industry and the relevant copyright societies to conduct such activities for bolstering the creativity and curbing the meanness of piracy. To sum up, the users are the part and the parcel of the active development of music industry. Music is created for consumption of the users. The users must be sensitive to the copyrights of the authors and the owners of such creative works. The copyright society, being representative of owners and the authors, must act rationally on behalf of its members so as to ensure efficiency, transparency, and accountability. Thank you.